So if you've been using Macs for a while, you're probably familiar with terminal commands that look like this. Matter of fact, a lot of people just call these terminal commands, even though they're a very specific type of terminal command. In this case, it's defaults write com.apple.screencapture type JPEG. The idea here is that you're setting a hidden preference. There's a preference inside of macOS for what file type to use for screen capture. PNG is the default, but you can use JPEG or PDF as well. But there's no place in the interface to actually select this. So you're left with going to Terminal, typing this command, hitting Return, and then a lot of times you also have to do something like type something like kill all system UI server, basically restarting that part of your Mac so that the change takes effect. Now, you may be familiar with this. You may have done this for all sorts of different settings on your Mac. You may see web pages that are recommending, oh, go to Terminal and do this. But what does it really do? What is this command actually doing? And it's actually very simple. So I wanted to take the time to explain it to you. What this is actually doing is it's just changing a little bit of text inside of a file. Let's go to the Finder. And in the Finder, here I'm going to go to my home folder, MacMost, but I'm going to go to the library inside of it. The easiest way to get to the library folder, because it's typically hidden, is to click Go and hold the Option key down on your keyboard, and you'll see Library pop up as an option. And when I'm in Library, I can go down and look at Preferences. And Preferences will show me all of these files, and you can notice the names look kind of like what part of that command is. And in fact, you've got one that matches that perfectly. You've got right here the screen capture, com.apple.screencapture, and then it's .plist. Now I'm going to open this up in a text editor so you can see it. And normally you wouldn't do this, but I want to show what this is. So basically it's just got some header information here, and then it's got a bunch of definitions. Key is what, and the string here is what it's set to. So location is set to the desktop. Okay. Type is set to JPEG. Ah, okay, so that's where the setting is. And sometimes if you look at this before you ever mess with it in Terminal, it won't even be there. Like the type JPEG, or it won't be there. It'll just be blank, or nothing will be there for type at all. Now if I were to go back into Terminal here and type this command again and change to PDF, now if I were to go and look at that file again, so I'll open it up again, you could see it's actually changed it to PDF. So that's all that that command is doing, is it's altering the text inside these little preference files. Now you don't want to go editing these files manually, because you can see there's a lot of nuance here. You know, there's this whole idea of encasing things in these tags, string, key, all of that. There's only certain things that can be accepted, like type, and it's got to be typed exactly that way, and etc. So you don't really want to mess with these manually. That's why typically these preferences are changed when you use something like system preferences, or like a preference inside of, say, in the Finder here. If I go to preferences, there's a bunch of selections here. These will change it for you in the right way, but when you don't have an option for it, that's when you have to go to the Terminal and use these defaults right. Most typical Mac users will never have to change any of these. But if you do ever change them, I think it's a good idea to know what exactly it is you're changing. You're just changing this little text file and changing a preference by using these commands in the Terminal rather than using a checkbox or a pop-up menu somewhere in some preference part of an app. Thank you.